for your kind words. Now I would request Mr. Joyner, Secretary of CPCI, for a special address. Over to you, Joyner Abdin.
Thank you, Sumayan Bhai, and Assalamu Alaikum, and good afternoon to you all. At first, I would like to just appreciate the proactive initiative from His Excellency Mr. Imran Ahmed Siddiqui, High Commissioner of Pakistan in Dhaka, and Mr. Sulaiman Khan, Mr. Kashif Jamil. I also seeing here Mr. Ghulam Nabi, who left Bangladesh just a few days back. And welcome again. Nice to see you in this August gathering. And actually, Bangladesh and Pakistan, two friendly nations. We have enormous potential of trade and investment for mutual interest. We have SAFTA, South Asian Free Trade Agreement among us, and other arrangement as well. But due to some reason, SAFTA is not active or not acting properly due to some political or other reason. But we feel that we have scope to work together between Pakistani business person and Bangladeshi businessman as well. So in this regard, I would like to say not only exporting or importing, but we have enormous potential for mutual investment as well. For example, as Pakistan has developed its corridor, economic corridor with China, so in that corridor, Bangladeshi investors, those who are willing to invest there, there is a scope, as well as Bangladesh government is planning to inaugurate 100 economic zones, special economic zone. All of these economic zones are inviting foreign investment here in Bangladesh. So there are economic zones for Korea, for China, for India, why not for Pakistan? So if Pakistani businessmen come forward with its government agencies also, then obviously we can accommodate few Pakistani investment here in our economic zone as well. So with this vision, I would like to say that Bangladesh and Pakistan both are competing in exporting market. For example, ready-made garments, we are competitor here. In terms of other few leather products, we are competing with each other, but we have also scope to help each other. For example, we can develop regional value chain, and one portion of value chain raw materials maybe come from Pakistan, and then it could be processed in Bangladesh. And as an LDC, till now Bangladesh is getting tax benefit in the European and US market. So these types of benefit could be utilized as well. Strategically, we have other scope. For example, we can share our mutual advantages with each other. For example, Pakistan is in advantageous position in terms of science and technology, in terms of few other things, but Bangladesh economy is growing faster than anybody else in the neighboring countries. So in terms of SME development, economic development, or cluster development, Bangladesh can share its experience with Pakistan, as well as Bangladesh can adopt best practices from Pakistan in terms of science and technology and other advancement areas. So I think in near future, both the countries will work together for mutual benefit. And I am welcoming all the Pakistani investment investors and businessmen in this first DCCI business conclave going to be happened in January 5 to 7. In the first day, we'll have an inaugural session at 11 a.m. Bangladesh Standard Time. And then after inaugural session, we'll have B2B matchmaking. Those who are willing or interested to invest or having joint venture or having foreign direct investment or having franchising here in Dhaka. So I know there are many food industries in Pakistan, those who are doing well in UK and other markets. So why not they come here in Dhaka and have their franchises? So first day will be for investment. Second day, Bangladesh export to other countries. What I mean, those who are interested to import Bangladeshi product to Pakistan, they are welcome for B2B session in the second day. And third day will be Bangladeshi import from Pakistan. So in this case, obviously Pakistani businessmen can have their product, showcase their product for that particular day. So with this keyword, I hope in near future.